Welcome to Maple Grove for the Section 5 3A Boys Soccer Championship. The number 3 seed, the Champlin Park Rebels, and the number 1 seed, the Maple Grove Crimson, meeting for a third straight year in the section title game. Hi, I'm Jay Wilcox, along with Sig Ligry. And Sig, not a huge surprise to see these teams meeting once again. Champlin Park knocking off second seed Osseo in their semifinal. Meanwhile, Maple Grove, number 1 seed in this section, but also number 1 in the state after a really good regular season that included no losses and just one tie.
Yeah, we saw them earlier this year, and I was really impressed by them. They play well. They're teaming, they're shooting, they're defending. Every marker, they're getting there. Champlin Park saying that they were a little bit under the weather last time they played against the Crimson, having some players missing and some were on suspensions. And they feel that they are now back and ready. They're at full strength and they're ready to play.
Yeah, Coach Brady Hicks telling me that the last five games or so, they've kind of been really at full strength, more so than what they had been, and feeling pretty good about things and trying to pull the upset here. We'll tell you about key players to watch for in tonight's contest, starting with the Rebels and Jamelia Fonda, one of those guys in the midfield that they feel like is going to have to generate some things for them tonight.
Well, watch for him to take control, get the ball up front, and try and set up some offense.
6 goals for him this year, 7 assists. For Maple Grove, a key defender for them back on the field tonight. He's going to give it a go with a cast on Frank Miller coming back from a broken wrist.
That's a big plus for the Crimson. They need that good defense, and he's going to be a factor. Good to see him back.
All right, should be an interesting one here tonight. The winner goes to the state tournament, and the loser will conclude a really good season anyway here to this evening. Champlin Park and Maple Grove, it's up next here on CCX.
In 1935, Topline Financial Credit Union was founded by workers from our local phone company, by people who dedicated their lives to keeping our community connected. At Topline Financial, that dedication lives on because we believe that dreams are achieved when we connect with each other. So if you're dreaming of buying a new home or car, or planning for your future, or saving for that next vacation, connect with us. We'll help you get there. Because connected, we all do better.
Beautiful evening for soccer here for this Section 5 championship contest. Really no wind to speak of, and temperature certainly cooler than what it's been the last couple weeks, but I don't think it's a bother at all. I think these guys probably actually enjoy it that way a little bit. You work up a good sweat running around out there anyway. So these teams have had a good rivalry, but of late it's been Maple Grove owning this rivalry in Champlin Park. I mean, I asked Coach Hicks, you guys really want to beat them? And he said, yes, but as much as anything, they just want to practice tomorrow. They want the season to keep going. And sure, that's always fun to hear, because as much as you'd like to think that, it isn't always true. Sometimes, the season feels long and people are ready to be done. But he said, our guys are definitely not, especially since we've been playing, much better soccer down the stretch.
Well, that's the big thing. And, they have been improving so much from where they were in the middle of the season. So it does make a difference.
So look at the Section 5 bracket. Maple Grove took a little while to pull away from Roseville in that semifinal. And Champlin Park, as I said, knocking off Osseo in the 2-3 matchup on the other side of the bracket after both teams had gone with quarterfinal wins. Champlin Park at Moundsview is always a tough out. Even in that 3-6, they were able to beat the Mustangs and then getting a win over Osseo. So Champlin Park, freshman goalkeeper Drew Yeager. There's a look at Coach Hicks for the Rebels. And Yeager's been their guy in most of the year in net and giving up about 2.5 goals a game. And Xander Waldrum, the senior for Maple Grove. And we are underway here. Maple Grove and Champlin Park. Rebels in white, Crimson in black. Gavin Chabika trapping it down. He goes down, but they still advance it now and up that right side. And knocked away there from the Crimson is trying to cross that ball, but they will get an early opportunity with the corner. Nope, gonna be a throw. high bounce to the front, and Yeager will come up and grab it, and Everett Johnston saying he was tugged down there, but didn't get the call.
No. He was hoping for that call, but did not happen.
Yeager booming it out beyond midfield. Crimson, though, getting up for the header. Banged ahead, but that one trapped down. Maple Grove able to force a quick turnover there. Sent out wide here and following up is Hallberg, but nice job to break up that pass. He gets it right back, however, but being pursued relentlessly there.
Oh, and then gave it up.
Rebels looking to counter.
Oh, what
Miller
a tackle.
Slipping down there and still made the play.
I think he did that deliberately.
Rebels looking to attack up that right side, and that shot will roll wide of the mark as Waldrum watches it go. Xander Waldrum, the keeper. There's a look at Miller, and just getting really used to that cast. He just got it on, and Coach Leininger from the Crimson was, you know, saying we're thrilled to have him in there, but we're a little worried that he might be a step slow. You know, you get out of the flow a little
right.
bit here being out, but they're going to give him the opportunity to see how he can play as you get a look at this foul call here. As O'Brien took the brunt of that one for the Rebels and now boomed straight up the field and then volleyed right back out. Crimson able to gain possession back there. We commented the first time that we saw them play too that one of many things you like about them, they move the ball well, but they also, unlike a lot of teams, they don't seem to be falling into a trap of being an entirely right-hand team or
left. Right.
They're able to use both sides of the field. And, you know, that
yep.
sounds simple, but a lot of teams fall into a pattern where they're just comfortable going one direction and not so much the other.
Exactly. They like either the left side or the right side, and that's their dominant play.
Ibrahim up the middle. That one broken up by Carter Mast.
Almost
Ooh,
a takeaway.
Nice takeaway there as speeding up the middle was Johnston. And that'll be a foul called against Maple Grove. So I recall that regular season game was quite physical. I remember we commented about how they were letting a lot go compared to maybe some of the games we see. Yafondo will put it back in play with the free kick here for Champlin Park. Right at midfield. Crimson there for the header and then flicked ahead by Gannon Ferens. Nice ball up the left side. Johnston able to run onto this one. Well defended there, though, by Samba Job. And it's going to be a goal kick here for Champlin Park's Yeager.
Johnston asking what happened.
Yeah, it's kind of one of those nights where you have to have a short memory and play through some stuff.
Yeah.
You know, you're not going to get every call you want. And that's obviously true for both these teams. And I know it's easier said than done. You're playing sports at any level. There's going to be times when you get frustrated. But
yeah, especially now when you're playing for the championship, you know, the section.
Kafima Sano, the top score for the Rebels, number 7, and 19 goals coming in. They did a pretty good job against him the first time around, though. Miller, one of those guys who was really up and giving him trouble, and I know he was eager to get back out here and play. Now, you might think, well, okay, you're using your feet anyway, it's soccer, but it's still got to be a little bit of an adjustment to get used to playing with that big cast on.
Of course, your balance is different. You know what's there.
Rolls out of play here. Job will take the throw in for Champlin Park. No score on the board early on here, and no real dominance yet for either club. This one served right up the middle, and they're able to get out front and shield off the Rebels' Trey Jones there. It'll be a call going against Champlin Park. They play direct straight up the middle, but that one misses everyone, and it'll go all the way to Jaeger. Don't see a whole lot of freshmen getting the start and goal in a section final in Class 3A especially, so Jaeger, I think, probably has a pretty bright future ahead of him in net for the Rebels. This one lifted up that sideline here. Get out of play, so a throw coming here for Maple Grove. Colin Ames will bring it back in play here for the Crimson and then sent right back out. Pass ahead there by Comcast, but then sent ahead by Champlin Park. Crimson nearly had it back, but then Rebels get another opportunity. Rothermel. Ames knocks that away. Man, and did a good job hustling to it to keep it alive as well.
Like I said, just keeping that ball in play was impressive. Was
Johnston looking to trap it down. Ooh, and then he got a shot away. It was blocked. Kept in play, but then it's over to the Crimson and served in there by Chabika, but that one well defended. Champlin Park didn't want to give up a throw in, and it almost cost them an opportunity. Sometimes maybe you take the safe route a little bit more than they did there. Coach Hicks was saying that's one thing they've, one part of the reason they've improved is they were making some mistakes in their own end earlier in the season that were costing them, and he said including in this Maple Grove matchup in the regular season where we, you know, just didn't make great decisions at times in the back, and it was costing us goals and in, you know, on occasion even games. So we've, you know, kind of really cut back on that, and that's been a big key. Send a head up the side here and a big brace for it. Johnston couldn't quite get there. He was shielded off and asking for a call there as Ruelas kept him away from it. Back pass to Miller there from Mast. And they'll try and serve one right up the middle, but Rebels there and ready. They've played well early going here. Obviously an opponent they're very familiar with, and everybody knows Maple Grove's had a very good team these last couple of years. The state runner-up last year, ranked number one this year, and here's a long drive, but it'll go wide of the mark there as Chabika trying to hit a corner there from deep on the field. So goal kick here for Drew Jaeger and the Rebels. Driven upfield, Miller able to get to it for the header. Nicely done up the left side and then broken up. They'll get a throw in though. Ames will trigger it in here for Maple Grove and then knocked out again. He'll get another crack at it about 10 yards further upfield.
Well, as long as you're moving the ball.
Ball lead up. Rebels trying to get it out. Sano with nice work there, and they'll get it left side. Nice step in there by Hallberg to break that up. And then knocked away from Johnston, but it will be Maple Grove possession here as they've kind of started to tilt the field a little bit. And there's Greg Leininger, one of the two co-head coaches for Maple Grove. Johnston getting a return pass. Now Chabika trying to sneak it over to Johnston. Good recovery defensively, but that one was setting up as something dangerous there for the Crimson. going to have a substitution now for Grove as Usman Toure will come in. Probably see relatively short benches here tonight, I would think. I mean, you gotta go with your best at this point, and by this point in the season, everybody's in pretty good shape, and then again, the weather is cooler now, too, and, you know, it'll vary, but I don't think... Let's just say you're not worried about anybody's feelings and when it's a section final. You got to play who you think is going to give you the best chance to win, and that goes for both sides.
Well, exactly. You're going to put your best players out there because you got a lot at stake.
Driven ahead, and Toure then blocks that clearing attempt. Get a throw in here for Maple Grove. And now they will make another substitution as Parker Carlson will check in. Ames with the throw in here for Maple Grove. No score on the board. We've played about 12 minutes of soccer here. Section 5 3A championship on the line here. Maple Grove, the top-ranked team in the state. So there's Justin Turner, the other co-head coach for the Crimson. And Champlin Park hoping to pull off the upset here this evening. Long throw into the box, a lot of traffic. It will be a goal kick here for Jaeger and the Rebels. Jaeger's been going short with the ball out to his defenders and will do so again. Maple Grove trying to entice him into a mistake here, trying to spread the defense out and see if they can't trap somebody and force a turnover.
That didn't work, so they're going to have to try it the old-fashioned way.
Throw here for the Rebels. Rothermel will switch fields here. Nicely done as he puts it onto the foot of Ruelas, coming hard up that left side. But Hallberg interrupted that one.
Wow, that's another nice stop by the Crimson.
Amici sending it ahead. That one knocked down, taken away. Good job there defensively by Fuhrborn for the Rebels. Miller stepping in to break that one up. And now Champlin Park going to make couple of substitutions, looks like. Levon Ibrahim, number 95, is in, and Michael Tu, number 19. Ouch. Stepping on the ball there was Sano, and looks like he's all right. He took a hard tumble. At 17, 18, you can handle that. If I did that, I don't know. I wouldn't be getting back up that quick.
I wouldn't be getting up at all. I'd just lay there.
Hallberg, no, actually, it's going to be out off of Maple Grove. It'll be a throw for Champlin Park. Willis will throw it in here for the Rebels. Overrun a bit by Abraham, but he'll get it back and driven upfield there by O'Brien.
Crimson trying to play an aggressive attacking of wherever the ball is.
Ames turning with it there. And a hold against Champlin Park. It'll be Maple Grove ball. I feel like Champlin Park's done a pretty good job against them so far, though. I mean,
yes.
Many of the opponents that Maple Grove played this year, they've kind of been able to dominate, and that really hasn't been the case in this one so far.
Well, it's been pretty even.
A They'll go short with the free kick and then look to serve it in from that left side. Out front, the header. Oh, and it'll go just wide. Miller got up there to get involved in the offense. And it'll be a goal kick here for Champlin Park. But smart play by Maple Grove to go short with that and then have an unimpeded serve out from the wing. And Miller did get ahead on it, but he couldn't quite direct it on the net.
Yeah, just inside the near post.
Jaeger this time will boot it away. Pinball's back over towards Sano. He stays with it and keeps possession. Sano, a dangerous guy up front for the Rebels. Ames getting to it nicely and finds Johnston. Crimson have some numbers up, but broken up there by Feuerborn.
Champlin defense staying in its position.
That pass knocked away, and they'll send it right back. Ruelas gets to it for Champlin Park, but sent it out of play. Hallberg will have a throw-in coming for Maple Grove. Toure knocked it over toward a teammate, but broken up there. Sent upfield by Abraham. Nice hustle coming forward with it. There's Bersham racing up. It went out off of the Crimson, though. Bersham saw an opportunity to join the offense and jumped in. Rebels again go short with the goal kick this time, then a turnover near midfield. Ooh, and that ball nearly got in there to up front. Now Sano. Sending it up that left side. Here's Max Dorn. Dorn getting a shot, and it'll roll wide. Pretty smart idea there to kind of go against the flow with that shot.
Especially since the keeper was moving to his right. That left the entire left side of that net wide open.
So Waldrum hasn't had the ball in his end much. That time, blood pressure rising a little as he sees a decent opportunity for the Rebels, but it was actually well defended in the end. At first they gave up a little more space than they wanted there, but at least they cut the angle and made it not a real easy shot for Dorn to try and sneak in. Tried to get that one to Sano, but punched out of there, and now Toure trapping it down. Tried to go around Feuerborn with it, but couldn't do so. To the outside, but that one read and intercepted by Hallberg, and then sending it up. Ooh, just knocked away from Carlson. Carlson trying to win it back here. And Crimson wanted a call, they didn't get it. Dorn on the left side here, that pass blocked, but it will be a Champlin Park throw. Boylis triggering it in, and the return pass kind of handcuffed him a little bit. Hallberg will lift it up, and Jaeger waits for the bounce to come into the box there so he can grab this one up. Crimson quickly win this one and try to go right to offense here. Parker Carlson. Amachis there, and knocked away. They couldn't quite come up with it. Kambongsuk.
Try the right side, but the ball goes over the touchline throw for Crimson.
Going to have a sub coming in for Maple Grove as Colin Merritt reports on. Ames will throw it in here. We're just past the halfway point of the first half. No score on the board. No great chances. Probably, I'd say, maybe one decent chance each way. Maple Grove's had the better of things territorially, but they have not dominated this game by any stretch.
No. Neither team has a shot on goal, but I'm sure that's going to change. as we were just halfway through this first half.
Ames' throw getting beyond Merritt. Ooh, a swing and a miss there. Almost led to a corner kick, but a good recovery down there. Didn't panic as O'Brien went back for it. And now we'll get a foul call against Champlin Park. Crimson fans were begging for that one, and at first they didn't think they were going to get it, but then whistled down. You would rather be at home, obviously, if you're the Rebels, but the good news is it's a pretty short little drive here. You don't
yes,
have
not that
far to go for fans to come over and parents. And
the surface is similar to theirs.
Merritt floating it back in and sent back out. Here's a long shot. It was deflected and took most of the speed off it as Yeager able to grab that one up. Maple Grove, of course, moving out of the Northwest Suburban Conference, so we'll be in the lake next year. But still, section-wise, still could be a matchup. And now here's Miller finding Hallberg right on the line. Hallberg turns and goes with it and was tripped up at play on. Advantage called. Carlson leaving it out to Chabika. Rebels doing a solid job defending that one then, and it's knocked out off Carlson. It'll be a throw here for Champlin Park. And subs coming for both teams. Oh, Chabika coming back in. Obviously, he couldn't have made a play a moment ago like I claimed. Sorry there. And back in for Champlin Park, Yofondo. Throw in for Champlin Park here as Ruelas will take it. Hallberg, and they knock it over now. Johnston finding Carlson. Carlson trying to take that left-footed shot. It was smothered, though.
That Champlin Park defense was right there to block that one.
Rebels able to win it. Here comes Sano, but knocked away from him on a good sliding tackle there. Hersham getting over to break it up. Throw, though, for the Rebels. Yofondo sending that one up the middle. Miller waiting for it and punches it out. I think that's been a key for this Maple Grove team is they've got solid players, you know, kind of at all three levels. And here it comes up to Carlson. You know, there's a lot of teams you say there's that one guy, if we can shut him down, we'll be right in good shape. It isn't really the case with them.
No, their depth is pretty impressive. If one player is not having a good game, there are two or three others to pick it up.
Foul call in against Maple Grove, so Champlin Park will get a free kick here. Third straight season meeting for the Section 5 championship. And Carlson picks that one off. I don't think they saw him as Fearborn kind of had a giveaway right to him. Johnston, he tried to return it. Fearborn intercepting this one, and he's able to knock it ahead. Bersham will be first to it here, drives it up the line, but not able to keep it in play. Or is he? Yes, he is.
It's
wow, look at that
there.
Spin on that one.
Can't believe that did not go out.
Yeah, it might be just the angle we're at. It sure looked like it was going to be flying out of play. Good speed up the side for Kembongsuk. And good strength to possess it as well. Yofondo sending it ahead towards Sano. Now Miller, the interception. Fuhrborn back to track it down. And Hallberg jumped in to take it briefly, and now they get it to Chabika. Spins around in place there and drops off a nice pass to Johnston.
It's a one on four right now.
Ooh, he almost got all the way through there. And then that breakout pass was briefly deflected. Now the Rebels looking to counter in a hurry. Wanting to go to Sano, but well read and taken by Ames. Sano is the one guy for Champlin Park that can definitely scare any team they face. 19
yes.
goals. He's very strong, very skilled.
Yep.
But the Crimson did a really good job against him the first meeting they had.
Yeah, they marked him pretty tightly, and they're doing the same thing here. That every time he gets the ball, they have somebody on him.
Ames broke that one up and then volleyed ahead. And foul called against Champlin Park as Yofondo was knocked down as he sent that ball up into the air. So free kick here for the Rebels. I'd say definitely called tighter than the regular season meeting.
Yes, I agree. Again, that's center referee is Paul Rizzo.
Kambong Suk playing it out to that left side. A nice, well, no, just couldn't quite keep it alive.
Get the throw on quickly, maybe too quickly.
Yeah, they're going to allow those subs to take place, it
yep.
looks like here, all of them.
Well, we have a second. ER1 is Eric Eichaker. Two is Tua Vang, and Dominic Crisback is the fourth official.
Hallberg will take the throw in for Maple Grove. We are scoreless here, just under 13 minutes to play in the first half. And one of the things Greg Leininger, the co-coach for Maple Grove, said is we might see a lot of offense tonight. And then so far, that's not shaping up to be the case. Both teams have defended very well. We haven't really had any big saves or really, you know, like phenomenal chances where you
no.
kind of start rising out of your chair like, oh, it's going to be a goal.
No, not even a bunch of quality shots.
No. And I think overall you'd probably have to say that favors Champlin Park. It's not a stretch to say that they're the definite underdog in this game. So, you know, the longer they stay even, you have to like it better if you're them, I would think. Ruelas, even though they are kind of an offensive-minded team, so I guess that counteracts a little bit what I'm saying, but, you know, certainly if you're the team that's looking to pull an upset, you want to give yourself a shot later into the game to maybe get one and take a lead and put some pressure on this undefeated Maple Grove team.
Yeah, that's just the thing. The longer they hang around, the better their chances are.
Chabika coming to meet this one. Kambongsuk knocked it away, though, and then played to the outside by Abraham.
But you have to like this Champlin Park defense. They've been doing a great job of staying at home, keep their position, attack the ball when it gets in their area.
Up the left side, and there's a great example. Is well defended again there. O'Brien doing good work. And that one hit sideways and out of play. So a throw coming here for Maple Grove. Ames will take the throw in here. Under 11 minutes to go now in this first half. Hallberg receiving here out on that right side, stepping in and tried to put it up for Chabika, but knocked out of there by O'Brien. Hallberg jumping in to take it. Here's his shot. It's deflected and it goes in off a defender's shoulder or back. And Hallberg will get the goal for Maple Grove. First real opportunity for either team. And it goes in the net. Kind of an unfortunate bounce
yep.
for Champlin Park as the defender got in the way to try and block it. And instead it skips off his body and in.
Maybe a fluke. Here we see it again. Right off the defender and into the corner. Ouch.
The one thing you like about Hallberg is the way he stepped aggressively toward the net. And a lot of times players will kind of, you know, drift out wide with that ball. And he saw an opening to go forward. And he's able to take that shot from long distance. I mean, obviously it's not a high percentage shot, but that's why a shot isn't a bad idea.
Right.
Things like that can happen.
Yeah, that's what we keep saying. If you have an opportunity, take it, because you can get a rebound or you can also get a deflection like you got there.
Second goal of the season for Hallberg.
And we have number four.
Yeah, Bersham, a little shaken up, it looks like.
He's coming out.
So Maple Grove getting on the scoreboard first with a little over 10 minutes to go in this first half. Just when we were talking about Champlin Park's done such a good job of keeping it close. And again, nothing wrong at all with what they did there defending that. It's just an unlucky bounce off of a body. You did your best to you know, square up and get in front of that shot. And it seemed, you know, you don't say there's anything wrong with the way Jaeger played that one either, because obviously he doesn't know what's going to hit somebody and change direction like that. So him coming off his line there was not a bad idea at all. Just one of those things. So we'll see if that changes the way this one's being played. Sometimes floodgates open a little bit when one team scores, but
I don't think so. I think Champlin Park is playing a good defense. Their head is in the game, and they're playing well. That was kind of a fluke goal as far as they're concerned, but they're still behind 1-0.
Feuerborn will take this free kick here for Champlin Park. I'll tell him it's got to be moved back a bit, so he will line things up and see if they can get going. Driving it upfield toward their right side. It's off of Ames. It'll be a throw for the Rebels. Oh, no, it looks like center referee's going to overrule.
Yeah, two says it's Champlin Park.
Yeah, I thought it was pretty clear that it should be off of Maple Grove, man, unless he just maybe signaled the wrong way.
Yeah, I think he did, because now it's
comes
correct.
Back out. Here's Kambantuk with a blast, and that one goes off Miller, so it'll be a corner kick. It was kind of the same type of thing there. A defender doing his best to block it and got a piece of it enough to slow it down, and that's better than going in the net, but
yeah,
it does lead to a corner kick. And Kambantuk will take it here for the Rebels.
First corner of the match.
Yeah, and the deflection there. Oh, boy,
oh
that
goodness.
Was Waldrum diving out to get a piece of that. From up here, it looked like it might be headed toward the goal.
I agree. I thought that was going to go in.
Rebels getting a good opportunity. That's why corners are so big in
yeah.
these section games.
We keep saying that when you get to this level, this time of the season here, you see it again. Look at this activity here.
Feuerborn with the header. Just got the left hand out on it. And, yeah, I think it, you know, it didn't have a lot on it, but I think it had enough that it would have gone in if he didn't get a finger on it.
Absolutely. As we're saying, at this level, at this time of the year, the set plays are key.
Yeah, it's hard to generate offense, especially when teams know each other really well, too. I mean, you know everybody's tendencies and all that. Wow, we've gone from no chances to two very good ones. One went in for Maple Grove, one almost went in for Champlin. Comes back to Miller here. He'll bang it out with the left foot. You like the response, though, if you're the Rebels. They didn't hang their heads after giving up a goal. Instead, they came back and almost got one of their own.
Well, that's what I was saying. I don't see Champlin Park backing off at all.
No, and here's where, now here's Toure waiting for it to come down. Here's where I think having so much familiarity with the team helps you a little bit. You know, if you're coming in against an undefeated number one ranked team and you don't know them very well, you're maybe a little bit hesitant or whatever,
right.
But these are all people that they've played a lot before. They know them, they maybe don't like them, or maybe do in some cases, depending on if they played together in the summer or whatever.
Right.
But, you know, you're not in any way in awe of an other team like this when you've seen them so often.
Yeah, and as in most teams, the players are playing in club teams or summer leagues, and they probably played with each other.
Rebels looking to quickly bring it ahead to Sano here as he trapped it down, but knocked away from him.
Straight up in the air.
It's going to be They're calling for offside there, and now he spotted it. So Crimson will get a free kick as we'll tick under 6 minutes to play in the opening half. 1-0 Maple Grove as Ben Hallberg drilling a shot that banked off a defender's body and then over the top of goalkeeper Drew Yeager for a 1-0 Maple Grove lead. And then Champlin Park nearly answered with a header goal off a corner kick, but a nice save by Xander Waldrum. And that'll be a trip. It'll be a free kick in a pretty dangerous spot here for Maple Grove, about 10 yards outside of the box.
And we saw this in the girls' game when things were tight. They got a free kick from about just about the same possession or the same position and ended up scoring a goal.
Yeah, Maple Grove girls defeating Spring Lake Park 4-2 in the Section 5 girls championship game right before this one for those just joining us or didn't get a chance to see that one. So Maple Grove trying to make it 2-for-2 here tonight. Toure, a rip. That one goes off a defender, and it will be a corner kick. So somewhat similar to the goal, although this one instead goes Karam's way wide of the net.
There's the deflection off into the black nether.
So a corner here for Maple Grove as Ike Duell will take it. And this one got over the keeper, and then Toure a swing at it.
There's just too many white jerseys.
Here's another try. Oh. Toure turns and fires, and that one rising up over the top as he had a couple of cracks at it there. Boy, Yeager, those are the kind that really scare you as a keeper. He tried to punch that corner kick out, and he missed it. He couldn't reach it. And that, once it gets over you, you're kind of like, uh-oh, I could be in trouble here.
Yeah, you end up in no man's land.
And then Toure gets, I mean, that is a blast from close range, but it sailed up over the net. Those are the kind that if you're the keeper, you hope it misses the net first and foremost, but you also hope it doesn't hit you in the face from that range. I mean, come on, there's no way you would have time to react.
That could be nasty.
It'll be a throw here. It's some good hustle to at least keep it from being a corner kick as O'Brien got over there. Hallberg will take the throw for Maple Grove. 3.5 to play in the first half. A 1-0 lead for Maple Grove, the top seed. Bounces loose in. The clear was first blocked, and now they get it out partway anyway. And now bouncing around, Ken Bongsuk trying to win that ball back. And it's going to be out off of Champlin Park. Hallberg will get a throw. Wants to go to Toure. A lot of traffic around him, though. Rebels send it up, and here comes Sano racing to win that one. He was kind of alone for the moment, though, so he had to keep his pace there to wait for teammates to help.
Yeah, they're still vastly outnumbered. Trying now to set something up.
Ruela serving one in with the left foot. Pretty well defended, though. And then the clearing try is knocked down. Sent in on net, and Waldrum coming up with that one. Maple Grove had a rare turnover there, a giveaway that nearly led to an opportunity. Quick throw in there, and then the clearing try blocked by Gannon Ferens. Comes back to Hallberg. They'll swing it around right side now to Hallberg. 2 minutes to play in this first half. 1-0 Crimson. Back they'll come to Miller. And that pass broken up. Sano hustling over, knocked it away. It'll be a throw, though, for the Crimson. Hallberg will take the throw. Sega is a little slow on the draw to realize that that's the fourth official helping to direct where they need to take these throws and kicks from. First, I thought it was a coach. And
no,
was
that's,
like,
a, that's the fourth official. That's...
Cross here, ooh, and Yeager snares it just before it can get to Toure. Well played on both sides there. That was going to be a perfect setup for a header there, but Jaeger stayed in a good position to be able to reach that one and keep it from becoming a chance. It kind of ends up looking like not much, but if he didn't play that right, it could have very easily been in the net.
That could have been very dangerous.
Rebels trying to make a push to get something late here as we're under a minute to play in the first half. Throw in coming for Maple Grove. Amici's up with it. And Poland to the middle now. Gamachis will drop it back. Still time here, about 20 seconds for Maple Grove. Now sent in. Feuerborn with the header. Halberg gets to it. He'll chip it to the middle. That one mishit a little bit. Will be a corner, but I think they're going to run out of time to really do anything with it.
Yeah,
maybe
they're going to be really quick to get this back into play.
Duel did get it off anyway with some help from the ball boy. So we have reached the halfway point in this one. Our score at halftime is Maple Grove 1, Champlin Park nothing. The Section 5 3A Boys Soccer Championship on CCX Sports, and we thank the Maple Grove Boys Soccer Boosters for helping us present the live coverage here this evening. We'll be right back with first half highlights and stats, and then our second half for the section title.
In 1935, Topline Financial Credit Union was founded by workers from our local phone company, by people who dedicated their lives to keeping our community connected. At Topline Financial, that dedication lives on because we believe that dreams are achieved when we connect with each other. So if you're dreaming of buying a new home or car, or planning for your future, or saving for that next vacation, connect with us. We'll help you get there. Because connected, we all do better.
Welcome back here to Maple Grove. Maple Grove leading Champlin Park by a score of 1-0 here at halftime of the Section 5 3A Boys Soccer Championship. Take a look at some highlights from the first half. To be honest about it, there wasn't all that much until later in the half. It was well defended, you know, good game and all that, but not a tremendous amount of opportunities. There was a header that went wide of the mark for Maple Grove, and then a shot here that's goes wide of the mark for Champlin Park, and those were kind of really the only real chances early on. But Maple Grove, Halberg stepping in to take that one, watches drive, goes off a defender and in over Jaeger's head, and then a corner kick that nearly goes in. Waldrum reaching out and just able to make the save on that one. And then Toure getting a rip from in close here that sails up and over the net for Maple Grove later in the half as we check out our first half stats.
And it's pretty close score, 1-0. Shots 6-4 favor of Maple Grove. Shots on goal, actually Champlin Park up by one there. Fouls 6-3 and corner kicks even up at one each.
Yeah, so really a pretty even first half. With
yep.
Maple Grove getting maybe slightly the better of the play, and they do get the one goal to go in, but Champlin Park very much right in this one, as you would expect in a section championship contest. 1-0 Crimson. We'll be back with more soccer here from Maple Grove in just a moment on CCX.
At Topline Financial Credit Union, we love getting to be part of our members' big moments. Whether it's making home improvements, going to school, building a business, or even getting married. An interest-only home equity line of credit with payments as low as $50 per month can help you get there. It's just one of the ways we're helping our members on their financial journeys. Become a Topline member and let us be a part of yours, because connected, we all do better.
Well, Welcome back here to Maple Grove as the Crimson leading the Rebels 1-0 here. 40 minutes to go. Second half of soccer about to begin here. And important beginning, I think, to this half, Sig. You know, you want to come out and just establish yourself, and but you also want to be ready to not give up something. Either way, if you're the team that's ahead, you don't want to let them quickly tie it. And if you're the team that's behind, you don't want to give another opportunity to the team to kind of pull away from you a little bit either.
Yeah, that'll make the climb a little bit more difficult. But Champlin Park has been holding their own. I would expect them to come out and attack pretty hard.
Yeah, I think all in all, they'd have to be happy with the way they played that first half. I mean, again, not a lot of good chances for either team. The one, unfortunate bounce for them hitting a defender on the shot, and then they almost had one off a corner. So they were not outclassed by any means by this undefeated Maple Grove team.
Not at all. Maple Grove moving from right to left in this half.
Yeah, and unlike in a lot of years in a section final, there is no big wind advantage, you know, going one direction or the other here. The flag is pretty much limp. There isn't much wind at all to speak of. So we do see that often on, section final nights where, like, the flow changes so much with the wind, but that's not really going to be an issue here.
I still have nightmares of that game you and I did when it was snowing.
Yeah, there have been more than one. I can remember quite a few. Ooh, nice interception there, Bersham. But then it goes out of play. We'll get a throw for Champlin Park. Job throwing it in for the Rebels. Knocked away high into the middle there. And Royalis playing it up. They get a little attack going left side here. Nice cross. Ooh, tried to get it to Rothermull. He was shielded away from it. A follow-up, and Waldrum has to make a save on a hard bouncer taken by Yafondo.
I think that caught them by surprise because he had some mustard on that kick.
Yeah, they kind of interrupted the original play or the first play, and then everybody kind of slowed down a little bit, and the follow-up actually was a good attempt there for Yafondo. And then if there had been any rebound, they had somebody there as well for that. Nice takeaway by Duell. And then sent over to Johnston, but he couldn't quite control it. Now he does get it back, however. Johnston shooting. And a nice stop there by Jaeger. Johnston, it looked like, the initial play didn't work, so you're kind of thinking like, okay, this is over, and then you got it right back. And I like the shot. He tried to go short side and sneak it in that inside the post there.
It didn't quite get there, so.
Yafondo trying to trap that one down. Crimson, though, getting it back. Jabika's pass blocked. And Yafondo stays with it, looking for Sano. Now Miller will tap that one ahead to Duell. A little too high with it, though. And Ruelas sending it up the left side. Sano trying to track it down. It'll be out off of Maple Grove. We get a throw for Champlin Park. Swinging around here. O'Brien, almost taken by Johnston. It'll be Champlin's throw, though, as Job avoided that ball when it was coming at him. And so that gets the Rebels the throw in here. Kambongsuk with a nice turn, stays in position ahead of Duell there, and then got the pass away. The shot chipped, and it's going to go wide. Waldrum reaching for it. I think he was actually fortunate he didn't get a piece of it, or it would have been a corner. It was going to be wide of the net. And that's how it turned out. Waldrum will take the goal kick here for Maple Grove. Waldrum didn't see a lot of action in the first half, but he was ready on that header off the corner kick and just got a piece of it. Crimson, nice rotation here. They get it ahead now. Kamachis knocked away. It'll be a throw for Maple Grove. Ames with the throw in. Good battle for it there, and the Rebels end up winning it. Get a foul call against Maple Grove. Yeah, just a little too physical on that, trying to body into him was Chabika there on Rothermel. I would say all in all, a pretty clean game. Now, I don't want to jinx anything, but I mean, the guys are, they're playing hard, and I don't mean there, you know, aren't some fouls occasionally, but we haven't seen anybody get like overly rough or
no,
you know, frustrated. It doesn't seem like. Here's a ball up the left side. Ooh, nice pass there. Broken up by Carter Mast. It will be a throw for Champlin Park. Yeah. I like the idea there to not take any chances if you're Carter. Just come over there and get it out.
And sometimes that's a safer thing to do.
Trey Jones will take the throw in here for the Rebels. See if he'll get it all the way in front there. Not quite, but knocked back out. Rebels trying to go right back on the attack. Instead, it's sent up the line. It'll be a throw for Champlin Park. Oops, we almost had two balls go in play there. You're going to make them do that one again, back a little bit farther.
There was a little bit of confusion on which ball they were going to be using.
Yeah, ball chasers were too good there. They got it in so quick. Hats off to them, by the way. We've kind of just become so used to that, but you and I remember way back when that wasn't really a thing.
Yep.
And the players had to chase it. I know the current players would be like, what are you talking about? But they had to go chase the ball down all the time. There were not youth ball chasers around at most of the games back many years ago, back in the olden days, I guess you could say. Kim Bong-suk will take the corner kick, and he had a really good one the first time around. They nearly scored on a header, and Rebels hoping they can work some magic here. Right out front, it bounces around, and it is in. It'll be a goal for Champlin Park. Kim Bong-suk might get this one himself. I'm not sure if any Rebel got a touch on that ball in close or if it's just in off the corner.
They'd probably give it to the nearest player.
Boy, see Kim Bong-suk with the corner. There's bodies there. It bounces around.
It's bouncing around, yeah.
And it goes in. And I guess Kim Bong-suk will get the credit for that one. As I don't think it hit Jones. No, it just hit the defenders. So Kim Bong-suk will score it. And we are evened up at 1-1.
You know, we keep saying at this level, the set plays are the ones that really count. And Champlin Park draws it 1-1.
Be a throw here for Ames.
Well, that'll give the Rebels some momentum.
Chabika trying to turn and go with it here. Now he'll instead send it over right side. Crossing pass here, knocked away. Now it's Maple Grove's turn to kind of get fired up and, you know, get it, try and get that one back. Here comes Jones for the Rebels. Looking for Sano right up the middle, battling with Miller. Sano pushes it ahead to himself. Miller got back and kept him from getting a clean look at the net anyway, and then Miller takes it away and drives it upfield. And if you're just joining us, Miller coming back off a broken wrist, playing with a cast. First time back in their lineup tonight. They really weren't sure if they were going to have him or not. Arguably their best player and certainly one of their leaders for sure. Here's Chabika turning and firing. Ooh, and Jaeger has to make a big stop for the Rebels. Chabika kind of long and lean, and he's able to turn and get that good shot away. I thought that one had a chance.
You see it?
Good pass, and he does a nice job of not wasting any time there, too.
Yep. Immediately took the shot, and it has some power on it.
Duel balling it high in the air. Pass broken up. Now Rothermel with it for Champlin Park. He's going to dish it out to the left, Ruelas. And then that long pass taken by Hallberg. Rebels saying it hit Hallberg on the way out, and the center referee agrees, so they'll get that call. Send it back across to O'Brien with a little space to work with here for Champlin Park. He's going to send one long up the middle, trying for Trey Jones. And the keeper, Waldrum, will come out and get it here for Maple Grove. Champlin Park tying it up early in the second half. Off a corner kick. We are even at one apiece here in the Section 5 3A final. Bounces around a bit. Sano knocking it over to Jones. And Hallberg, the interception. Sent ahead toward Chabika. Just lost that race to it. And then Chabika will be called for the foul as his momentum carried him into and right over O'Brien. So free kick here for the Rebels. Yeah, just kind of tripped
and fell on him.
Good call. But good hustle by both guys there, too.
Yep, both trying to get to the ball.
Grimson able to get the steal. Ooh, and then a nice little back pass toward Johnston. It was knocked away from him. Now the race is on. Ooh, nice sliding tackle there by O'Brien. Ames giving it to Duell. Trying to sneak that one through. It was blocked. It'll be a throw for the Crimson, I believe, here. Yeah, a couple of subs coming now. Long throw in toward Toure. Couldn't get control of it, though. Rothermel's pass knocked away by Duell. And Sano able to come up with it. Here comes Sano. Look out.
Oh.
Hersham knocked it down. Boy, good thing he got that one, or it might have been a breakaway.
He was on his way.
Sent long there, and Waldrum able to come up with that one. Waldrum was close to being over the line there. He had to be careful to give up a corner by grabbing that one from behind the goal line. As get their feet tangled, and another collision. The second one will be called against Champlin Park. Kind of got an undercut situation there, and Johnston's a little slow to get up. Not that they weren't going hard in the first half, but you can tell it's the second half now. They're just
a little more aggressive.
Yeah,
yes.
People are going just a little bit harder, a little bit more physical.
So it'll be up to center referee Paul Rizdal to keep the peace.
There's the first collision, and then the second one came over the back and got into the back of his head a little bit there, too. Duell will take this free kick. Duell chipping it to the front. Bounces around in tight. Turnaround attempt. Oh, and it rolls just wide there for Mast. Goal kick for Champlin Park.
Golden opportunity to getting quality shots is at a premium in this game. See it again.
Yeah, and sometimes it's the people kind of lingering along the edge of the fray here that get the best opportunities like this one. And boy, there's two dangers there. I mean, obviously of a shot going in, but also if it hits a foot and redirects there, either an offensive or defensive guy, that would have been tough for the keeper. Instead, it just went all the way through and wide. Toure lofting it for Johnston. He puts it out front. Knocked away as Jaeger was out of the net. Oh, we might have a penalty kick coming up here. Looks like we will. Maple Grove's going to get a PK, and we've got an injured Crimson player down there in front.
can't quite make out the number.
Maple Grove's going to get an opportunity to take a lead here on a penalty kick. As Jaeger was way out, we believe it's Johnston who is down. See another look as Toure volleys it toward Johnston and passes it over and then tripped up by the keeper, Jaeger. Oh, he did stick his leg out.
Yep.
At first,
yep.
I was going to say, I'm not sure I like this call, but it looks like he did that on purpose.
I think you're right.
So Maple Grove will get a penalty kick. Looks like it's going to be Duo who'll take it, but first they have to tend to Johnston. They might have hit knee on knee there.
Well, he's getting up a little gingerly.
Yeah, he doesn't, not exactly going to sprint off the field.
No,
he's in some pain.
Apparently he says he can walk by himself, so that's a good sign.
It's still going to hurt, but it's going to feel better if this BK goes in the net, right?
It will feel a lot better.
Ike Duell looks like he's going to be the man called on to take that penalty kick.
And again on the PK, it's just a guessing game. The best way to score is to shoot in a corner so the keeper can't figure out how to get there. He's trying not to look at where he wants to place it. Good idea.
Waiting for Johnston to be all the way off the field before they allow this penalty kick to be taken. And now it looks like we are about ready, and Duell will get the whistle and the go-ahead to try and give the Crimson the lead. Ike Duell stepping up, fires, and a great save made by Jaeger. Jaeger, the freshman, with the stop. After the penalty kick was awarded on a play where he was called for the trip. So he comes up huge for the Rebels, a big boost for them. This will be a throw-in for Maple Grove. Jaeger, wow, huge stop there.
That was gigantic.
Duell tries to go low with it, got it into the middle of the net just a little more than he would have liked there.
Yep, Jaeger made the right guess. What a big save that was.
Yeah, and Jaeger, I mean, it's kind of like doubly important because he was the player that was called for the trip
right there,
too. So, big confidence booster for that young keeper, the freshman. And we are still even at one apiece. Well, and just in general, you know, you kind of don't like to see games decided on penalty kicks. But looking at the second look at that, there was certainly a call that had to be made. He stuck his leg out into him on purpose, it appeared. And a foul call here against Maple Grove. Knocked up field here, got by the first wave of players, and now Rebels do gain control. Pushed ahead towards Sano. Miller and Sano racing. Miller got there first.
No call.
And they keep on battling. It'll be out off of Champlin Park. Miller pumped up, though, to have made those plays and just to be back out there.
Certainly glad to have him back.
Let's see, is this going to be, this may not be a throw in, it might be a free kick. The foul might have been called on the second one, it looks like, yeah. Ruelas will be taking this free kick with his left foot here, looking to hook this one in. Chance for the Rebels to try and take their first lead. Knocked away, but it's going to be a corner kick. As Mast getting down to chest trap that one out of there, but it'll be Ruelas with the corner. not too far from where he just took the free kick. Ooh, it bounces in the air, and then a follow-up try was knocked down after Waldrum tried to punch that one out. Then the shot goes high and wide. It'll be a goal kick here for Maple Grove, but the Rebels putting some pressure on.
Putting a lot of pressure on.
And Johnston is able to come back in for Maple Grove. Jabika going out, so Johnston, a good sign that he's able to come back in. Talked about that in other games. Boy, knee-on-knee hit can really hurt, but it's usually not as bad as when you get, you know, a twisting or
right.
Something like that. Nice block there. Johnston tried to drag it around the defender, but couldn't do it. Yafondo. Nice move to the middle. Whoops, but then falling was Kambongsuk, although he still got the ball away. They called advantage there. And then that pass a little bit too far. It'll be a goal kick here for Maple Grove. Nearing the halfway point of this second half, and we're not quite to the point where you could say next goal wins, but next
knows.
Goal will be awful big. Let's put it that way in this tie game in the section final. Boomed out to midfield and then volleyed right back into the Maple Grove zone. Ames drives that one up into the air. Kambongsuk with a header. And then knocked back out. Toure turns with it, and that pass, though, broken up. Pretty good idea. Ames sending it ahead. Amatrice hits the referee with that one.
I think he's going to, he stops play, so we'll get a drop here.
Still hard for me to get used to that. In every other sport, the officials just considered part of the field. If it hits them, it hits them, and
right.
They keep playing. But
not in soccer. Hey, it's
chip to the front. Ooh, and Jaeger will scoop that one up. Rothermo had it taken away. Ames. Gamachis. Puts on the brakes. Did the ball stay in? Apparently
yes,
so.
It did.
Crimson will swing it over right side to Hallberg. Can kind of see a sense of urgency for them now that they're really looking to, once they get possession, to really get upfield in a hurry, try and generate chances. Now obviously they haven't really been in this situation all that often. They were tied once this year by Andover, but haven't really been pushed this late in tie games too often, I wouldn't think, this year. Sano sending it out. Some room to work with as a follow-up. Rothermo will serve one in, and header, it bounces in the air. Miller will send it up. Player down for the Rebels, but play goes on. Now we get the call.
And
as
stoppage.
Jones is down. That ball that was served in, I don't know if he got hit by an elbow or...
I think it's just a collision.
See another look at
here.
It. He and Hallberg both went up.
Yeah,
oh, they hit heads.
Head to
yeah.
head.
You saw Hallberg hold his head a little bit too, and then he came over. You know, it was nobody's fault or anything. They're just both going for the ball. So Dorn will come in to replace Jones. Looks like Jones presumably will be able to come back, though he seems to be not too bad off out there.
Yeah, they may give him a quick check and make sure he doesn't have any kind of an injury. With the drop.
Johnston breaks that one up. O'Brien will give it to Feuerborn. And Ruelas up the left side with it. Miller trying to knock it down. Sano, though, getting to it. Sano getting to the outside, trying to go around Miller. Ooh, that one got pretty physical.
Yeah, no call.
Miller lifting one into the middle. Now Johnston. They'll bring it to Ames and work it to Bersham. Looking long up that left line for Johnston. Oh, nice job by O'Brien, though, to break that up. It did get out of play, though. It's a throw for the Crimson. Another look at this good battle down low, and
it's kind of shoving each other, and down he went. No call. Sano doesn't agree with that.
No, I was going to say that what you think of that call depends on which color you're wearing in the on the bench or in the stand. I'm sure Maple Grove thought it was legit, and Champlin Park probably not as much.
Good point.
Knocked away. It'll be a Maple Grove throw. Ames kind of trying to go long with it. Headed out of play, though. Job got over to break that up for Champlin Park. We are past the halfway point in the second half. 1-1 our score. Champlin Park scoring early in the second on a corner kick. Maple Grove a bit later was stopped on a penalty kick as they made a bid to take the lead back. Ames will throw it in here for the Crimson. Rebels with the header, but that's going to result in a corner kick for Maple Grove. Farron's coming back in for Maple Grove.
And this is the first corner in the half for the Crimson.
Duell will take the corner kick. Goes far post with it, and the header, and Jaeger making a stop there as Miller putting that one. It was hard to tell if it was going to be. It might have been just wide anyway, but Jaeger wasn't going to take any chances. Back and forth in the air they go at midfield. Ruelas lifting one up the left side. Sano trying to knock it ahead. Miller knocked it down, but then Sano grabs it, plays it ahead, and Waldrum will come out and get it. As Rothermo really didn't have much of a chance at that one. It was a good idea, but they just didn't quite click. Waldrum, a high bouncer into the Rebel zone. Toure trying to win that ball, but no go. Instead, Yafondo will drive it ahead, looking for Sano. The race is on here. And Rebels fans wanting a call here. Do we get one? Looks like no.
No. Wow.
Waldrum will boot this one away. And that one would have been just outside the box had they called it. It would not have been a penalty kick, but it would have been awful close. Rothermull turning it back, trying to go to Sano here, and he will run it down. Sano stepping toward the net, cuts to the middle, fires, it's off the post, then off the other, and then rolling over the top.
Oh no, he had an
open
net.
Oh, that was so close. It hit one post and then the other. It couldn't have been more than a couple inches from rolling over that goal line. Great moves by Sano here. This is why he's their most dangerous scorer. Look at that move. And then, oh, that was awful close to going over the line there. Oof. I don't know. I'm not so sure. I mean, the ball's got to completely cross the line.
Yes, it does.
But it looked very close.
You don't see that too often. Ricochet off one post all the way across to the other one.
Well, and then the follow-up opportunity looked like was going to be a chance to score two, and it went over the net. Oh,
yeah,
my
I thought he was going to just use his chest to push it in. But.
Oh, Champlin Park coming oh so close to taking the lead right there. And it goes out now. It was not out of play before that. The Rebels, or at least one of their players, kind of stopped. And instead, we get a throw-in for the Crimson. Nice takeaway there, though, by Kumbong Suk. Ames now, though, will get to it. Kumbong Suk trying to play it ahead. Ames blocked that. It's a throw for Champlin Park. Kumbong Suk. And I think we have an injured Maple Grove player. Kind of bent over there, that's Ames. Center referee checking with AR there to see, you know, did you see what happened to him? And looks like it is going to be a free kick for Maple Grove. So they are apparently felt strong enough that he had seen a foul that he relayed. Oh no, I'm sorry. Going to be free kick for Champlin Park. So O'Brien will take the free kick. Crimson coach is pleading to that fourth official over there. Bud O'Brien will get the free kick here for Champlin Park. Sending one into the box. Nice header, though, by Duell for Maple Grove. Now Ruelas getting to it. He'll send it back in. Blocked. Here come the Rebels again, though. Looking for Sano. Job. Trying to step between defenders, and then Joe blocks that one. It'll be a goal kick here for Maple Grove. Champlin Park not content to just tie this one up. They've had their fair share of the play here for sure, and just about took the lead.
They are hungry.
What Coach Hicks was saying pregame kind of is really borne out is that I don't think they saw our full strength team the first time around. And there's Dorn trying to get to it. Waldrum almost lost it. Dorn coming in there. Maple Grove didn't like it, but I kind of agree with Dorn. It looked like, hey, if he bobbled it, it's fair
yeah,
game for
fair
me.
Game. Yeah, that's fair game.
Official came over, did say something to him, but.
The
right
ball
there,
loose.
He's kind of
got it now.
I could see both sides
yeah.
here, but.
Yeah. Probably a good no call.
Yeah, I agree. You never fault somebody for, you know, trying to jar the ball loose a little bit there. Here's Toure with a rip. That one will sail over the net. He's dangerous, although that shot got underneath it too much. Jones coming back in, Rothermel coming back in, as is Yafondo for Champlin Park, kind of for that stretch run. There's Chabika coming back from Maple Grove. About 12 and a half to go, and now you're gonna see both teams going all out. They already have been, but.
Even more.
Yeah,
if
that's
there can
possible,
be that.
Yeah.
Everybody is playing with a high intensity.
Run down here by Sano. Drops that pass back. Oh, and Rothermo couldn't handle it. Sano frustrated. He made the right play, but it just wasn't handled. Ooh, as Johnston tried to drag it around the defender. Now Chabika is met. Kumbong Suk dropping it back. That was a little dangerous, but Fuhrborn will drive it upfield. And then Sano with the header. Ames, who's back in there. He'll send it up. Oh, just missed Chabika, but then following up, they almost had a chance. Johnston over to Chabika. Stepping to his right. Pretty well defended, though. Now Duel cutting in. He'll fire. That one hits a body and doesn't make it toward the net. Now Rothermo receiving. Playing it up the middle there, but that one's intercepted. Frank Miller. A little bit of room to work with here, so he'll go out wide to the right. Hallberg, who has Maple Grove's goal here tonight, serving one in. Gets all the way through to the left. Back for Chabika. Down he goes. Johnston, though, with a turning shot. It's right into the midsection of Jaeger, who makes the save.
Jaeger sitting there waiting for that one.
Injured Maple Grove player way back at midfield is Bersham. Bersham getting up pretty quickly there. Looks like he will not have too much trouble getting off here. I didn't see what happened to him. Little Sarkala coming in for Maple Grove. If they get a little team huddle there.
Yeah, that's unusual.
Referee telling both teams, all right, we're ready to go here.
There's the drop.
Jaeger directing his team here to move upfield. He's going to punt this one. Farron's getting to it here for Maple Grove. And knocked away. Royalis ran into some traffic, though, trying to get it upfield. Ames chipping that one ahead with the left foot. Jaeger avoids traffic and wins the race to that one. Now I'm feeling more confident in saying next goal wins. We go under 10 minutes to play, still 1-1. Each team a very near miss. Maple Grove, a penalty kick that was stopped, and then Sano nearly put Champlin Park ahead. A shot that went off each of the goalposts, rolled right on the goal line. And I don't know. I mean, if we had replay, I'm not 100% convinced that wouldn't have been called a goal. But, of course, we don't. So that one's out off of Maple Grove. We'll get a throw for Champlin Park. That header will come right back out of play. Throw for the Rebels again. Johnston got to it first. That'll be a foul against Champlin Park, so a free kick here for Grove. Hallberg will line it up. Actually, he will not. Duel will take it here on this left side. Even this far away, this free kick is certainly something you have to be a little bit concerned about if you're the defense.
Yeah, he can land it down on right about the 20-yard line where everybody's parked and get a header.
Rebels, though, get to it first. Trying to clear, but Ames jumps in, gets it back. Not for long, though. Taken back by Yafondo. Wants to send Sano. See if they'll play to the keeper, and they do. And then Sano tripped up, mast, and the Crimson fans and bench are hot. They think that was a little bit of a intentional clip there. And now we're going to have a discussion with the AR, see if he agreed. After Mass clears it, watch Sano. Oh, he stepped on his foot. Yeah.
He gave him a little love tap on the shoulder, but he did step on him.
So it will be just a free kick here for Maple Grove, and it'll be Waldrum coming out to take it. That's one of those where, you know, if he really saw it, if the center referee really saw it, he might consider a yellow there. But when you don't see it and you're kind of getting, you know, relayed information, I just can see why you wouldn't call that.
Yeah, it's difficult.
And you'd like to say the benefit of the doubt that he didn't do it on purpose, but I kind of think maybe he might have. But then again, there have been some physical stuff the other way, too. So.
Yeah, it's become a very...
Here's Sano with a drive, and Waldrum just gets enough of it and will keep it from being a corner kick as well. Whoa, Xander Waldrum coming up with another big save right there. Whew. Seeing again why Sano is so dangerous. Look at that shot. It got on him quick. It almost got by him. But he fought it off, and then it was also able to keep it from going over the line for a corner.
Well, that's a heads-up goalkeeping.
So we stay at 1-1, another near miss for Champlin Park, and their top scorer, Kafima Sano.
But they keep knocking on the door.
This will be a throw for the Rebels here as we're down near 6.5 to play in the second half. Still tied up at 1-1, the Section 5 3A boys soccer title on the line. Chabika putting it out for Hallberg. Intercepted there, but then knocked off the Rebels. It'll be a throw for Maple Grove. Chabika receiving this pass, trying to get a step to the outside. He crosses it toward Johnston. Ooh, and it goes just over the net. It's going to be a corner kick. Defender was the first to get there and knocked it out. So Maple Grove will get a corner out of this. Another look, a nice ball there, and good job by Job to get back and get in the way, but he couldn't keep it from being a corner. Now we get a stoppage. Ooh, and a yellow card given to the Champlin Park bench.
Yeah.
Talking loud enough to be heard there, apparently. And so they did not agree with the last call or calls there. And
so now Maple Grove with the opportunity.
Duel will take the corner. Sends it in, there's Jaeger, a save, and then it's cleared. Whoa, that was a good opportunity off that corner for Maple Grove. We've seen some chances both ways. And then it's a throw for the Rebels coming up. Outstanding contest here tonight, some twists and turns. Another look at that corner. Oh, and Jaeger's right at the line. All he could do to fight that one off. And then got help from his D. Barron's bringing it to the middle. Rebels wanted a call there, didn't get it. Knocked over toward Chabika. And his pass knocked away.
He thought he had somebody with him, but he was wearing a white jersey.
Jones trying to carry it past Duel. Boy, they get physical.
Oh, yeah. This, I think the rest of the game is going to be like this.
Remember earlier when I said it hasn't been very rough or anything? I rescind that comment.
Taking that one back, huh?
Little give and go action here for the Crimson. Carried in deep. Rebels can't clear, and now it'll come rolling to Jaeger. That one looked relatively harmless at first, but then had the opportunity to turn into something there as they got it into the box. O'Brien playing it out to the outside. Job with good hustle to keep that one alive. And then a nice turn by Rothermullen, and then he is fallen onto by Ames, and that's going to be a yellow, I believe, against Ames. Yes, it is. Fell into the legs of Rothermel. Really great spin move here, and then Ames. Yeah, those
launched
are dangerous.
Himself at him. Yeah.
Carlson will come in to replace him here. Things getting heated. Both teams know what's at stake here. O'Brien will take the free kick here for Champlin Park. Header flicked into the front, and Waldrum will not take any chances. Comes out and smothers that one. And leave it for Frank Miller here, and he'll play it up that right side. Now they send it long toward Toure. Sano dropping it back. They tried to go back to Miller, though took it. Sent ahead here toward Ferens, and now Johnston. Toure to the outside. Gamachis has a little space. Oh, he passed it. Instead of taking that shot, and then it was broken up. Duel. Leaving it for Hallberg, trying to chip one in. That one sent back. Now Ike Duel will give it right back to Hallberg. Keep it rotating right. Now the shot taken, blocked, but it'll be a corner kick. Approaching 2.5 minutes to go. They came awful close on the last one. Now Maple Grove, another corner kick opportunity. This one will be Carlson taking it. See what they can do on this corner. Looking far post, that one goes over everyone. Rebels will knock it out. It'll be a throw for Maple Grove here on this near sideline.
Under 2 minutes, so I'm going to start agreeing with you. The next goal is it.
Ames taking the throw in. Ooh, and a high bounce. It's going to be offside, I think. Ends up in the net, but no goal.
Fans thought that was a goal, but we knew that was an offside.
Yeah, I heard the whistle beforehand, so.
Yeah.
I don't know if it was a foul or an offside, but either way, everybody was pretty much stopping by that point. Out of play, it'll be a throw for the Crimson here. A minute 20, overtime looming. Ferens battling for it with Job, and he got the ball to Toure. Keep it moving toward Johnston, but that one picked off. Hallberg will run it down here for Maple Grove as we're under a minute to play in regulation. And Sano pushes it ahead, hustling after it. They're going to play it to the keeper here. Waldrum will keep it rotating out toward Ames.
They're going to get one more rush here for Maple Grove if they maintain possession.
Ooh, and out with the header is the keeper because he was out too far to play it with his hands, and then the shot driven wide. Jaeger came out, and I thought for a moment he wasn't going to realize that he was beyond the box there. And that would be trouble, of course, if he grabbed it out there, so he went with the header instead. Got a stoppage for an injury to Johnston.
So Johnston will have to come out.
18 seconds remaining regulation. Chabika back in.
And the overtime rule is it's a 20-minute sudden death. You get two 10-minute sessions after the first 10 minutes, to switch sides immediately and keep playing.
Jaeger driving it upfield. And obviously now we don't no longer have regular season overtime, so it'll be the first overtime for these teams, of course, this year. And we have reached the end of regulation. What a second half. Champlin Park tied it up. Maple Grove almost went ahead, but were stopped on a penalty kick. Champlin Park had two more great chances after that. And we still sit at 1-1 at the end of regulation. We'll take a timeout and come back with our overtime. The winner goes to the state tournament here, Section 5 3A Boys Soccer Championship.
At Topline Financial Credit Union, we love getting to be part of our members' big moments. Whether it's making home improvements, going to school, building a business, or even getting married. An interest-only home equity line of credit with payments as low as $50 per month can help you get there. It's just one of the ways we're helping our members on their financial journeys. Become a Topline member and let us be a part of yours, because connected, we all do better.
Welcome back here to Maple Grove. We get extra soccer here tonight. 1-1 our score at the end of regulation, and getting sent for the first overtime here. Third seed Champlin Park, number one seed Maple Grove here, playing for the Section 5 3A Boys Soccer Championship. And here's a look at the overtime rules. As Sig mentioned, it's a 20 minute or two tens as we refer to it. And they'll change ends, and then we go to a shootout after that, and then they would alternate shooters after the initial five if no one has won at that point. So again, we're not seeing overtime in regular season play anymore, so this becomes a little bit even more of a special thing here. Really outstanding game.
It has been.
And I think, you know, maybe possibly to some people's surprise, I would actually say Champlin Park had the better chances down the stretch than Maple Grove did even.
They did.
All of that doesn't matter now. It's whoever can come through here in this overtime session.
Yep.
You've also, in the back of your head, already know who you want to be shooting if you go to PKs too. And it's, you know, I'm sure both teams would say, let's not even do that. Let's get one of us. They both would like to get a goal and not have to worry about that, but it's still something you have to plan for. Yafondo sending one up here. Miller stepping in with the header. Boy, and we mentioned too how physical it really got down the stretch. Now, you want to be playing hard, but you also you don't want to cost your team. Here's a rip. Oh, and that one goes wide. You don't want to cost your team, you know, give a chance up because you were, you know, retaliating or something like that. Here's Carlson with a shot. Ooh,
that was closer than I thought.
Yeah, it was kind of, from this angle, it was hard to tell if it was going to be way wide or, I mean, it was wide enough, but still your heart beats a little faster there if you're the Rebels, but they able to dodge one. Here comes Champlin Park. Jones trying to drop it over to Sano, and Crimson trying to clear it out of there. Couldn't quite do it. Now Miller will be called for the push. Actually, it'll be against Champlin Park.
You can see Champlin Park desperately wants to get Sano into the offense.
Oh, yeah, there's the push on Jones. Yeah.
Yep.
And then he went down, but he actually did do the initial push there, which was the call.
Yeah, he did the deed.
Toure leaving it back for Chabika, and then he'll play it out wide to the right. Carlson trying to get a step there, knocked away. Albrecht able to knock this one down. And we'll swing it over to the left side here and a race on for it here. Look at that hustle. Job kept it alive to Sano. Kambongsuk now sending one up the middle. Miller with the header. Yeah, it's fair to say it's ultimately number seven's foot they want the ball on if you're Champlin Park. Sano,
yes.
He had two very near misses in that second half. One that hit one goal post and then danced right along the goal line and then off the other. And then another rising rocket that Waldrum saved. Here's a shot, and Jaeger drifting back to make that save. They were hoping to maybe catch Jaeger having crept up a little too far and see if they could lob it over him, but he got back. Miller heading this one high into the air. And that'll be a foul against Maple Grove here. Free kick for the Rebels. 6:40 to go in the first overtime session. Sent in, trying to find Sano in the middle of that pack. Job had it knocked away. It'll be a throw for Champlin Park. Going to Sano with it. They double him. Tried to drag it around the defenders. Crimson did a solid job though, but then it's Yafondo knocking it down. He's going to serve one far post. And Landrum read that one well and gets to it. They'll roll it up the side and then the pass behind Carlson. So a throw here for Champlin Park. It's interesting because you want to go all out to get a goal and win the game, but at the same time, you also want to avoid the big mistake too. So yeah. I think it seems like we've seen just maybe a little bit more cautious play here in overtime than what we saw down the final stretch of the regulation play.
No, that's a key point. You want to be aggressive and score, but you don't want to make an error and give your opposite team an opportunity to take the game away.
Sent long up the right side. Fuhrborn getting back to it for the Rebels. Got to be careful what he does with this one here. And he's able to play it ahead. Rebels fans wanted a foul. They don't get it. Oh, it's sent out front. It bounces high in the air. Deflects around, and it lands right near the goal. Whew. That one turned dangerous.
Well, it's been a game of what-ifs, hasn't it?
Ames will take the throw in here from Maple Grove. 4.5 to play in the first overtime.
This is the last effort. There's a header. The ball comes straight
Johnston
down.
Right in the middle of everyone trying to get up and get a piece of that one. Now we're going to have a free kick coming for Maple Grove in a dangerous spot. Just about 4 yards outside the box. Ike Duell will line it up.
So look for Maple Grove to flood the box. They'll be coming from the right. I don't expect them to take a shot at goal from here. I could be wrong.
I don't know. I wouldn't be super shocked either way. Nope, you're right. He goes low with it at a high bounce off ahead. Rebels trying to clear it. And then a bicycle kick, but that one doesn't make it toward the net. Oof, knocked ahead, and Yafondo was tripped up. It will be a foul call against Maple Grove. He took a hard tumble.
Yeah, he felt that one.
No, actually.
Well, I don't know. You can make a case either way on that one because he did run over him.
Yeah, he kind of jumped to try to draw that one, it looked like, but high bouncer there. And Sano will be called for the push here. Free kick here from Maple Grove. 2:45 to go now in this first overtime. Obviously still tied up as we're still playing. It's 1-1. Miller chipping it ahead. And he was tripped up as he kicked that ball. Now we get a stoppage and we might have yellow. Yes, we will. Sano I don't think it was for the initial trip. I think it was for talking afterward
Could
and
be,
complaining.
Yeah.
And I know Sanoa's feeling like, hey, I've been bounced around an awful lot.
This could be a factor because Sanoa is going to be sitting out for a little bit.
Michael, too, will come back in. Yeah, you don't want him off the field. Watch, just as Miller gets rid of it, then Sanoa kind of tripped into him. And I don't think initially we were going to see a yellow, but I think he turned and complained. And that was when the whistle blew again to stop the clock. Out front it comes off a Champlin Park player. And they will get to it to make it a throw instead of a corner, I think. Or did they? No, looks like he's pointing corner. It must have got out. Yep, going to be a corner kick for Maple Grove.
And this could be big.
Ike Duell will take it. And we've got guys out front getting into it a little bit as they're trying to get position.
Yeah, everybody's jostling for their position. Maple Grove obviously wants to get a header.
And the header by the Rebels
landed
on the back of the net. Oh, that would have been a terrible way to end the game on an own goal. I don't care who wins either way, but you'd hate to see that for a defensive player to put one into his own net as Rothermel heading it, but not in the right direction.
Oh, just over the crossbar,
the
too.
Top of the crossbar.
Wow.
So another corner here.
A little deep.
And that one knocked down. They can't clear. Oh, and a follow-up is driven up over the top of the net. And it'll be a goal kick here for Champlin Park.
That's a situation when that goal looks so big and you get all that adrenaline going and ball goes over the top of the net. Here, see it again?
Boy, the initial header was going to be right on, but it was knocked down and then the follow-up.
Can I see that again? Because I thought number 8 had his hand on it.
Sano coming back in for Champlin Park after he had to sit out briefly with that yellow card. Half minute to go in the first overtime, foul on Chabika of Maple Grove.
Let me see that one more time.
See the initial header.
Yeah.
I
think it did.
It's possible it did hit a Rebel there in the hand. But I think they ruled, incidental. Here's Toure. Driving one over the top. Now, I said earlier he's got a dangerous shot, and that is true. However, he hasn't been very close to hitting the net on any of them.
True.
Get too much. And that's the end of the first overtime. The teams will just switch ends and keep on playing that second 10. So some drama with those corners. And we'll keep on going here in the Section 5 3A Championship. Outstanding contest.
It's been something.
Champlin Park, I think, like we said coming in, I mean, based on the whole body of work for the season, you'd have to have said they were the underdog, and Maple Grove has had a great year, but it's been very even throughout the night.
Yeah, well, like you said earlier, when you're talking to the Champlin Park coach, this is a different team from what they had before.
And they have played quite well here this evening.
Yes, they have.
You think some of the chances both teams have had, and you go, oh, they're so close to putting it in on a few occasions, but that's kind of what you hope for, what you should see in the section final like this. Out off of Toure of Maple Grove. Get a throw here for Champlin Park. You take it however you can get it for either team here, but I think both teams, is again probably not all that anxious to see it come down to penalty kicks, really.
No, that's one thing you don't want. You want to do it on the field, in play.
Miller sending that one ahead. Johnston trying to win it back as Job couldn't quite. Yeah. Let's see. No, yeah, it'll be Maple Grove, so I think the official just signaled the wrong way there. Substitution for the Crimson. And as Ferens will come back into the lineup here. Looking toward Johnston, and it bounces loose, and Ruelas sending it ahead. Sano will trap it down. He and Duell both go down, then they both get right back up. Sano looking for an opening, wanting to rip a shot there. Leaves it for Yafondo. He'll bring it back out, and Pureborn will send it up. Crimson back the other way. Johnston, oops, that one didn't quite connect. Kambongsuk sending it ahead, but picked off. Now a nice ball up the line. Carlson crossing it, and that one's driven out of there. It'll be a throw for Maple Grove. Dangerous potential set up there for Maple Grove. Carlson hemmed in along the sideline. Who knocks it out? It's off the Rebels. It'll be a throw for the Crimson. Hallberg will throw it in here for Maple Grove. Toure with the header and then volleyed out, but they still haven't cleared it. Here's Carlson, a shot. Oh, and Jaeger.
Just got there.
Ranging to his left, a low shot on the ground. That was definitely ticketed for the net if he didn't get there.
That's great reaction. He saw that kick coming, and he knew that left side was open.
You know, and I even though it didn't end up being a goal, I like the idea of where they went. So many guys are trying to rip the ball so hard into the top corner that they miss the net. And putting that one in a tough, low spot sometimes can be hard for the keeper.
Corner
kick here, defender slipping and maybe injured. Oh, that's like double whammy for Maple Grove. Not only do they end up giving up the corner, but get an injury too. Well, it might be a cramp. Yeah, it looks like it must be. Not that that's not bad, but because Mast quickly jumped in and was stretching the leg out. I think that must be Ames down there. No, I'm sorry, not Ames. That's Miller. Another look at this last try by Carlson. You know, it's not a super rocket or anything, but it was well placed.
It was dangerous.
And then here's Miller. Watch. Oh, that's it. He didn't slip. His calf was cramping to the point where he
couldn't stand.
Couldn't get up. And now it looks like we have another person cramping.
And the trainer comes out.
It is Miller still. Well, keep in mind, Miller has been out for a couple weeks with that broken wrist. So maybe not surprising that if anybody was having this issue, it would be a guy that was, you know, just coming back.
Right, hasn't had the playing time. And then go into overtime or double overtime now.
Sano, those guys have been battling hard all night long, but Sano reaching out, trying to help him up, but then Miller still cramping, or coming back with the cramp. Just trying to get it worked out. Rebels are going to have a corner kick coming up once Miller is able to work his way off the field with that cramp. sometimes you can, you know, they go away quick and sometimes they don't. And right. This obviously is the latter right here, as he was going to try to start to get up. And then all of a sudden he was, oh my gosh.
I'm trying to see if they can put pressure on that, on the right leg.
Well, and I think it was in the process of getting up that it seized up again a moment ago. So trying to not have to walk on it if possible, but
I think he's going to hop off the field.
So the Rebels will get a corner kick as we resume. Maple Grove had some near misses on corners. Now it's Champlin Park's turn to see if they can't end it on this corner. Ruelas will take it. That's how they scored earlier off a corner. Putting it out front, and a header goes high into the air the other side. Fearborn knocking it back toward Kambangsuk. And it's going to be a corner again. We'll do the same thing over. Ruela sending it in. Oops, that one got a little too much of it. It goes all the way over the net and out of there. So Maple Grove dodging a bullet there. Back-to-back corners for the Rebels don't quite pay off. Jabika is going to come back in for Toure now for Maple Grove. Waldrum driving it up to midfield. Rebels able to clear partly there out to midfield, but Crimson able to win it back here. Looking to Carlson, now into the middle. They return it out toward Carlson. Carlson getting a step and a good tackle there. It's going to be a corner, though.
Yeah, it should be a corner. It is.
So now it's Maple Grove's turn to get an opportunity with the corner.
Well, it's been back and forth and back and forth. Here we go.
And
nobody
only
there.
One player there. It's a Rebel and knocked out by Yafondo, but it'll be a throw now for Maple Grove. Ball lead into the box here. Rebels trying to clear it. And now they get it to midfield anyway. Hallberg, though, here comes Sano. Battling it out there with Ames.
Ames won that one.
Back, and we're going to get a foul call against Sano, I think. He just kept going and got a push in the back. So we will get a free kick here for Maple Grove. Sano's got to be careful. He got that yellow earlier.
Yeah.
You don't want another, that's for sure. You can see he just turned on the jets here, and he and Ames kept on going,
yeah,
and then he got that last shove.
Yeah, you're right. He's lucky he didn't get a yellow on that one.
Duel with the free kick here for Maple Grove. Sending one in, but Rebels up for the header. Long attempt here. Jaeger will knock it down. 3:35 to go in the second overtime. 1-1. Champlin Park and Maple Grove here in this Section 5 title game. A shootout could be looming. Ooh, battle for it there. It will be a throw for the Rebels. Or is it a free kick? Looks like it must be a free kick. Yep, Ruelas. He will look to send one in. Jabika coming back to meet it, does a nice job trapping it down, and he'll play it up. Long run for this one. Ooh, Carlson kept it alive, but then it rolls out. Let's see who it's on off of. It will be Rebels' throw.
It was.
Duel dropping that pass back. And now getting frantic again here. 2:20 to go in second OT. Fondo breaks that one up, but it goes out of play. A throw for Maple Grove. And Miller is coming back in. He had the bad cramping problem a couple minutes ago, but he's well enough to come back now. Alberg, who has Maple Grove's goal here tonight, serves one in. Ooh, and there's Jaeger coming out in traffic to scoop it up. He'll distribute it out to the right, and then they're looking long for Sano. Way across toward Carlson, but had a little too much on it. It's a throw here for Champlin Park. Ruelas will trigger it in. Chabika's pass broken up. Now Duel dropping it off to the left. Sent right up the middle, and the keeper Jaeger will come out to get us. We go under a minute to play in the second OT. And the shootout order probably being discussed a little bit, or already has been, for both these teams.
Yeah, the coaches have already picked out their five players.
Probably a lead in practices have been testing things out a little bit in that regard, too. Driven back toward midfield, and Chabika took a bump there as he got that header, and now he comes back and throws an arm into a Rebel and gets called for it. 20 seconds to go in this second OT. Chabika pleading his case, but that's not going to get it now.
You never do win that.
O'Brien sending it up at the header. Under 10 seconds to go. Chabika, long one ahead. Jaeger comes out and catches that one. And we have reached the end of the second overtime. And we will go to penalty kicks to decide this Section 5 championship. Some good action. Most of the near misses or excitement came off corners, and we have played 100 minutes of soccer here, and a tie score at 1-1 as we get set for penalty kicks. We'll take a quick timeout and then come back with our shootout here. Champlin Park and Maple Grove in the thriller here on CCX Sports.
CCX Media, your source for great local programming, is available on Amazon Fire TV, Apple TV, and Roku. Our free app allows you to stream all three of our channels live. You also have access to a large on-demand library, including full sporting events and daily newscasts. To find us, go to the store, search CCX, and download our free app. Then sit back and enjoy all of your favorite local content. The CCX Media app, available on Amazon Fire TV, Apple TV, and Roku.
Well, you don't see this too often, both goalkeepers meeting to talk a little bit about the shootout. However, you also don't see this very often. Luke Steen is going to come in goal for Maple Grove for this shootout. Obviously, they must figure he's got a better opportunity maybe to stop some of these shots than Waldrum, who's played the whole game. I'm guessing that's something that was pre-decided ahead of time, obviously, there. I don't think we saw any injury or anything to Waldrum. They were warming up Steen before the game. Before the shootout, late in that overtime session, I saw him on the field, coach kicking balls to him. So both these teams getting set for the shootout as they send their five, and you saw Sano making the universal signal to keep talking there to Miller. So Steen will be in goal for Maple Grove. And the first shooter is going to be Afondo for Champlin Park. So our first penalty kick attempt here of the shootout. It is Yafondo versus Steen. The shot is good. Rebels get that first all-important one to go.
And that's how you do it, into the corner. Even if the keeper guesses the right direction, that's not going to be stopped.
Shooter for Maple Grove here is Mast. Here's Mast coming, and he also puts it in the corner.
Same place.
Yeah. There was some guesswork there by Jaeger, and he went the other way.
Yeah, and again, it wouldn't matter if he guessed right. That was way out of his reach.
Sano will be the second shooter here for CP.
Here it is.
Yeah, and as we, you know, discussed in past years, in reality, pretty much everybody should make it unless you make a mistake. I mean, a goalie maybe can guess perfectly and get a diving save once in a great while, but that's a big net to be defending with nobody else there
absolutely
to help. Sano fires. Ooh, he got a piece of it, but it still goes in. Steen guessed right and got a hand on it, but Sano had enough on it to calmly put it away. 2-1 Rebels. Another look at that shot,
got
his
right
hand on it.
Just got a fingertip on it.
Chabika will be up next year, looks like, for Maple Grove. In theory, the team that gets to shoot last kind of has the advantage, but if the other team starts out with makes, and then it maybe sort of turns. Chabika firing, and he'll hit it in. Pretty much in the middle, but he still got it past. And both teams 2-for-2 here in the shootout. Another look as Jaeger guessing, and Chabika decided to just go straight middle with it. And that's one where if Jaeger had just stood his ground, he might have had a chance at it, but that's
right.
A big if. Kambangsuk will be the shooter here for Champlin Park. Can either goalie come up with a stop, and will that be enough to get the W if they do? And the captains for the Rebels, Kambangsuk, walking in, and he puts it away. Not too bad of a guess by Steen, but still, again, couldn't get it. And 3-2 Rebels now. All five shooters have scored. Yep, just diving the other direction. This will be Johnston to shoot here for Maple Grove.
And he would like to tie it up.
Johnston, the shot. Ooh, almost went too high, but he hits it.
I thought that was going to go over the top of the net the way it was taken off, but he got it just underneath it.
I actually did too, and I think Jaeger was obviously hoping it would. This one had the look of one that might have been rising too quickly and go over, but nope, right under the crossbar and in. And we're even at 3 through 3 shooters. This will be Trey Jones for Champlin Park, shooter number 4 of the initial 5. Nobody has missed yet. Jones rolling it home for the goal. 4-for-4 now for Champlin Park. You know, as much as we say, the advantage is and should be with the shooter, you don't often see, a 5-for-5
right.
performance in these shootouts because there's a lot of pressure on, and sometimes the shooters kind of outguess themselves or get nervous or whatnot, and don't hit it the way they want to.
Right, and they put it right in the chest of the keeper.
Ike Duell, shooter number 4 for Maple Grove. Duel, the shot, and he nails it. And we stay perfect. Each team is 4-for-4 as Ike Duel calmly deposits that one in the corner. No problem with that one. Nope. And now it'll be Sam Feuerborn to shoot for Champlin Park. As they try to go 5-for-5 in their initial group of shooters. Feuerborn, the lefty, and this one stopped. Steen comes over to block it, and now Maple Grove will have a chance to win. And guess who? Frank Miller, cast and all, cramps and all late in the game, will come up with a shot. There was Steen guessing right, lunging to his right, and he makes the stop. And here we go. Can't believe it. So here. Now Frank Miller will step up, trying to get a storybook ending. He gets his wrist in a cast, comes back to play the section final, and has a chance to send Maple Grove to the state tournament.
It's absolutely quiet in the stands. This is big.
Miller. Jaeger trying to outguess him. Miller, the shot, and he hits it, and Maple Grove wins.
Wow, what a final.
Frank Miller makes it 5-for-5 for the Crimson. Steen getting the one stop they needed on Champlin Park's last shooter. And Maple Grove will score the W here this evening as they will win it 2-1 in a shootout. The shootout was 5-4 Crimson.
There it is, the winning goal.
Unbelievable game here this evening.
Well, Champlin Park really, really came into this game with a good game plan. They executed it well and end up closing out the season, losing in the shootout.
Yeah, outstanding battle here this evening. And Champlin Park, obviously this hurts an awful lot right now, but gosh, they played a heck of a game here. Amazing second half and overtime and then ultimately shootout in this one. And Maple Grove will be heading back to state for the 10th time in program history.
It was a tough win, but they earned it.
We'll take a timeout, come back with our awards, and then eventually hear from the Crimson here. Maple Grove wins in a shootout here this evening to take the Section 5 title.
CCX Media is the first place you go for local news and sports. But did you know you can sign up for those stories to go straight to your inbox on our website? Simply go to ccxmedia.org. Click on the subscribe button and from there choose which notifications you want to receive. Then we'll send your favorite CCX Media news, sports, and city events straight to your inbox. Sign up now at ccxmedia.org.
What a game here this evening in the Section 5 3A Boys Soccer Championship, and Maple Grove going 5-for-5 in the shootout and winning this one over Maple Grove, or over Champlin Park, excuse me, despite the Rebels playing a tremendous game here this evening. They had some chances to win, and both teams did down the stretch too, the Rebels, we talked about it earlier, how they, you know, maybe are a better team than what they looked like earlier in the year just because they didn't have their full lineup at various points of the season. And they showed it tonight. I mean, this is a good group.
Yep.
And they gave Maple Grove all they could handle. And I'm not just saying that or anything. They were right there and could have won this game.
It was that close. And I think the biggest play was that penalty kick save that they made during the game that kept them in the regulation time.
And Maple Grove going to be headed back to the state tournament. They win the Section 5 title for a third straight season. And they stay undefeated, and I would think there's a reasonable chance they'll be the number one seed for the state tournament as well with that undefeated mark, and they come in, you know, number one. Not a sure thing. Obviously, they got to vote on that and all, but certainly a possibility. So the Crimson celebrating with the trophy. We will take another timeout and come back and hear from the Crimson in just a moment. Maple Grove over Champlin Park for the Section 5 championship.
CCX Media, your source for great local programming, is available on Amazon Fire TV, Apple TV, and Roku. Our free app allows you to stream all three of our channels live. You also have access to a large on-demand library, including full sporting events and daily newscasts. To find us, go to the store, search CCX, and download our free app. Then sit back and enjoy all of your favorite local content. The CCX Media app, available on Amazon Fire TV, Apple TV, and Roku.
Welcome back to Maple Grove. It was anything but easy, but the Crimson survive in advance in a shootout here in the Section 5 championship with a win over Champlin Park. And a couple of the seniors that helped make it happen, joining us, Andrew Waldrum, first the keeper. And wow, wild game. They came out. They had some great opportunities in that second half that you were able to stop. You know, how much fun was tonight?
I mean, it's always fun playing out here, especially at home, under the lights with all the people that shows up. You know, it really gives you that confidence boost to really just play your best. And, you know, I got to give all props to the team. You know, they played their hearts out tonight. And at the end of the day, grit is what got us the win. You know, all of us played with our hearts. You know, before the game, we had a big speech and everything in there. But it wasn't just me in the back. You know, it was all my defenders, all my midfielders. I got to give them all the love, too.
And then you go to a shootout, and they replace you in goal. That's something a little bit different, but a team guy you have to be to say, okay, that's fine. He's a keeper that's really strong too.
Yeah, Luke and I in practice, you know, we take turns on the PKs, and some of the ones I see him say are just unbelievable. You know, we play a team game, and what a team game would be without letting my backup play a little bit, you know.
Champlin Park came out, and their coach was telling us before the game that, you know, they'd had some injuries and stuff. He didn't feel like when you saw them in the regular season that they had played as well as what they were capable of. And I think that kind of showed tonight. I mean, they gave you all you could handle, it seemed like.
Yeah, that's true. They came out swinging, you know. In the regular season, we beat them 4-0, I think I remember correctly. But it was different circumstances. You know, it was a regular season game. They hadn't been playing all their starters, I don't think, the entire time. But, you know, tonight they really wanted it. But I think we just wanted it a little more.
Heading into the state tournament now. Last year you guys got all the way to that championship game. And you feel like the chances are pretty good again to advance again like that?
Yeah. I mean, I didn't get very many minutes against the first time we played Champlin. So tonight I really wanted to capitalize. Especially because it's my senior night, and this is going to be the last time I ever play a game at home. You know, emotions were setting in and everything, but, you know, I had to play it cool. Yeah.
All right, Xander, thanks for joining us. And let's talk to Frank Miller here. Coming back with the cast on after the wrist injury, you get some cramps late, and then you come back and get the winner. I mean, is this kind of a storybook night for you?
I couldn't ask for anything better. I mean, I've been coming here for, you know.
Yeah! Oh! Oops, I saw that one coming a little bit here. A cold night for that here, but now tell us about this night, how special it was for you, Frank.
I mean, I'm cracking up because, like, I mean, I got my best friends here. You know, I've been coming here for, you know, 10 years. I mean, I've had two brothers come to the program. You know, I was talking to my dad earlier this morning. He was in tears because, you know, we woke up, we both look at each other. This is going to be our last game, the family's last game. At this freaking stadium, you know how much that means to me. It's you know, it gives me emotions, you know, but I couldn't ask for anything better. I mean, we played our hearts out. Champlin had a great team, but we just wanted it more, I guess. Right, Xander?
That's right.
You saw Luke get that save. What was kind of going through your mind then, knowing that you were the fifth shooter?
I looked at my guys. You can ask any one of them, and I said, I'm going to freaking win this game. No doubt in my mind I knew I was going to win that. I was going to put that in the back of the net. And I was already thinking about the celebration before I shot that.
Heading into the state tournament now, how do you guys feel about your chances? Do you expect to be the number one seed based on the regular season you had? Or?
Well, I sure hope so. I mean, I think we went undefeated and we put a statement out, you know, to the Minnesota that, you know, we mean business, right? We got, you know, the best defense, best goalkeeper in the state, and, you know, hopefully no one can score on us, you know, in state. And I think our chances are good, and I'm looking forward to it, man. I think we're best team in state.
All right, Frank and Xander, great job tonight. Congratulations on the win, and have fun in that state tournament.
You too. Thank you.
All right, Maple Grove defeating Champlin Park here in a shootout tonight. Great contest here at Maple Grove, and the Crimson win it over the Rebels for their third straight Section 5 title. For Sig Liger and all of our CCX crew, I'm Jay Wilcox. Hope you've enjoyed the action tonight, and thanks again to the Maple Grove Boys Soccer Boosters for helping us bring you live coverage of this Section 5 title game. Good night from Maple Grove.